weaponizing social media. One mom warning other parents that white supremacists and other extremists are trying to recruit your kids online. What teens might think are just snarky jokes or memes could turn down a dark rabbit hole towards hate. The I-Team investigates how kids are being manipulated and how to identify the warning signs. News 4's Stephen Holt.
Do you have white teenage sons? Listen up.
It was a cautionary tweet by mom and blogger Joanna Schroeder that quickly went viral.
Social media and vloggers are actively laying groundwork in white teens to turn them into alt-right white supremacists.
She was shocked while looking over her son's shoulder as he scrolled through Instagram.
I saw an image of Hitler come by. He double-tapped it to like it.
What he thought were just jokes were memes tinged with racism, sexism, and anti-Semitism. Her post, retweeted 81,000 times, is a warning.
Being desensitized to something like the Holocaust, it's horrifying.
If there's anyone who knows what it's like, it's Yusuf Abdul Latif. This devout Muslim was once a white nationalist skinhead.
This is the skinhead tattoo.
He too was exposed to white power as a teenager back in the 80s. Yusuf grew up on Long Island as Jeremy. It was when his family moved to Florida, far away from his friends, that he started searching for an escape.
A lot of anger. You know, I dealt with my father's death.
He found an outlet in music, but the record he picked up was hate rock.
And in this song, they're talking about how the white man is oppressed.
And by listening to that record over and over, the ideas in the lyrics slowly started to resonate with him.
Say, I can't find a job. This is the reason. You're looking for scapegoats.
That search for meaning is even easier today.
Everybody's just a couple of clicks away from some of the more extreme spaces online.
Oren Siegel is the director of the Anti-Defamation League Center on Extremism.
I can't think of any more mainstream space where hatred is being normalized than on our phones.
Since 2012, FBI hate crime numbers have gone up. 2018 saw more than 7,000 hate crimes.
Who can create a nastier misogynist meme? Who can create an even worse anti-Semitic photo? You don't know who's reading it, how that will land on them, and then what they will do.
Look no further than several recent mass shootings. Walmart in El Paso, a synagogue in Pittsburgh, and a mosque in New Zealand. Investigators said all three suspects had displayed extremist views in online forms.
Online spaces, even the darkest ones, actually provide that sense of belonging.
It's all this false thing, oh, you're part of a fraternity. We're all the white race.
Words, pictures, even numbers can represent extremist ideals. Let's take a look at some of the common ones. Snowflake, a disparaging term for a person who is seen as fragile or too sensitive. The ADL's website has more than 200 hate symbols commonly used by extremists, like white genocide, fear that the white race is dying because of immigration and non-white populations. Beta refers to men who don't assert male dominance. The OK symbol, sometimes used to represent a W and a P for white power. There's Pepe the Frog, a cartoon appropriated by the alt-right to make a heavy situation seem lighter or like a joke. Then there are numbers that become alphanumeric codes. 18 represents the first and eighth letters of the alphabet, AH, for Adolf Hitler. Schroeder suggests parents research these to open a dialogue with their kids.
Here's where that comes from, and here's how it hurts people.
In the 90s, Yusuf found his way out of white nationalism. He now has an interracial family and says Islam saved him.
I deal with difference amongst individuals in a different way.
To start the conversation with your kids, we posted a list of common extremist themes, words, and images, and things to look out for on our website, NBCNewYork.com. Check back to you.
All right, Stephen, thank you very much.
Thank you for watching this video from NBC4 New York. You can subscribe by tapping the button below me, and on the left you can see our latest updates, investigations, and digital exclusives. We'll see you next time.